Let us start our science class. In previous class, we discussed about the new chapter. We discussed new chapter, that is a how do organism reproduce. Yes. We come to know that what is the definition for reproduction and what are the different types of reproduction. Just tell me, student, just will recall what are the two types of reproduction: asexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. By taking examples, we discussed about the asexual type of reproduction. In that, we come to know that budding, regeneration, fission type, upon that vegetative propagation, these are the some of the examples for asexual type of reproduction. Now, what about in higher plants? What about in hibiscus plant or else what about in mango tree? How they are going to reproduce? There are different types of reproduction, that is a sexual type of reproduction. We know that in sexual type of reproduction, there is a formation of gametes, both male and female gametes. Yes. Now, we'll recall in higher plants, that is in angiosperm. Yes. Which is a reproductive part of the angiosperm, that is a flower. Flower has both. In hibiscus plant flower, they have both male and female parts, reproductive parts. So we have studied by drawing the structure of the flower, typical flower. We discussed about the parts of the flower and how they are going to reproduce. As a product of reproduction, we got as a result the seed and fruit. Yes. Now, in last session, we studied about the reproduction in higher plants. Next, what about in animal, what about in human beings? Whether we are examples for asexual or sexual type of reproduction? Yes, we are the example for sexual type of reproduction. Then it should be, in our case, there should be a formation of gametes, both male and female gametes. Yes, once the organism is producing gametes, when it is matured, after the maturity only it is going to produce the gametes. What happened next? What happened to that gametes nest? Yes, immediately it is going to fuse. That fusing of male and female gametes are called as fertilization. We studied in our lower class. As a result of fertilization, there is a formation of zygote formation. Later, the development takes place. There is a formation of embryo. Next, there is a formation of new organisms. Now, while discussing about the fertilization, there are two types of fertilization. What are they, student? They are the external fertilization and internal fertilization. We'll see how they are fertilizing in animals. So in today's class, we'll study about the sexual reproduction in animals. Okay, write down the heading: sexual reproduction in animals. In animals. In plants, we come to know that how it is in animals. Now, we know that fertilization process. Now, there are two types of fertilization, that is external fertilization and internal fertilization. First one is external. Second one is internal. Name itself indicates that what is external and what is internal. Just think of, student, just think of the word meaning, student, external and internal. What happens in external? Fertilization takes place outside the body of an organism. If it is internal, means fertilization takes place inside the body of an organism. Come to know? Yes. Now I will tell you the definition. In external fertilization, fertilization takes place in, or else fertilization and fusion takes place inside, sorry, external means outside the body of an organism. Usually we know that fertilization takes place inside the body of a female organism. Okay? Yes. Can you give any example for this external fertilization? All the primitive organisms and adapt aquatic animals, aquatic organisms are example for this external fertilization. Can you take one simple organism, aquatic organism? Yes, that is a fishes and frog, amphibians. Many cases we'll discuss what about in fishes. Have you seen the eggs of the fish? Where it is going to keep the egg? Yes, it is like hen, like a frog, it is going to keep outside. Next, where the fertilization is takes place? Outside the body of the female. When mature fish is going to give egg, it is laying egg outside the body or else in water. Later what happened? There is a fertilization takes place. Okay, does not need any body for the fertilization. It is not takes place inside the body, so it is take place outside the body, that is external fertilization. The process of fusion of male and female gametes takes place outside of the female in an external medium like water. Okay, next we'll see what is internal fertilization. Here what happened? Fusion, that is a fertilization process, takes place inside the body of a female organism. Like human beings, like female organism, we are the female human beings. In human beings, the female organisms are carrying this gametes, and the fertilization takes place inside the reproductive part of the female body. Come to know, no? So you can give the example to this, no? Yes, what about the tiger? What about the cow? Yes, what about the elephant? Yes, just think of and tell me which is the examples, such as these examples are comes under in internal fertilization. Okay, yes. Next we'll see about the reproduction in human beings. Okay, this is in general animals, we included both fishes and this one. Now we'll see internal fertilization. Upon that reproduction in human beings particularly, we are going to study in our in 10th standard only. We are studying about the human reproduction. Okay, we know that in human beings there are two sex, that is a male and female. They are both male and female are going to produce their own gametes called sperm in male, ovum, that is egg in female. Okay, so we are going to study the reproduction. How reproduction is takes place? What are the different parts involved for the reproduction in particularly human beings? Before that, we have to know which organism or as which who is ready for the reproduction. Who is ready for the reproduction now? When the organism or as when the human beings, either boy or girl, when she is go to or as facing the puberty, or else when she reaches to the adolescent stage, then only she can reproduce, or else it is ready for the reproduction. It indicates that the maturation is indicates that she is ready for the reproduction. Now what is that maturity, or else what is that puberty? Two terms, different terms we used. What is that? What it means is when we reaches to the adolescence age. Just to compare the body structure of an infant baby and an adolescent boy or girl, we can see number of changes in their body. Yes? Yeah. Now, if you are going to see both male or as a boy and girl, we can see number of different developments or as different changes in the boy as well as girl. Now, we'll discuss what is that changes. If you are going to consider a boy child, When he reaches his adolescent stage, it indicates that he start to mature. So, when he is matured and when he is maturing, there are some changes takes place in his body, both internally and as externally. Now, you can see, actually the maturity takes place between 12 or 14 years, like that, a 14-year-old. That time it start, okay, approximately I said it may vary or else it may change in each individuals, okay. Now what are the changes? If you are going to see that one, when you are in first standard, how is your body, and when you are in 10th standard, how is your body? See how much height you gain, the body design itself change. What about your voice? When you are in first standard, how melodious voice you had, boys. Now what happened? It is changed. Your rough sound, some are getting very rash sounds you will get. Upon that, you can see the Adam's apple in your, that is a larynx sound box. It is moving up and down if you are going to see your throat. Okay, that is indicates you are reaching the age of adolescence or you are started to mature. Okay. Upon that, there are many changes like the facial hair, like mustache and beard. Upon mustache and beard, same as that pubic hair. Upon that, in sweat and sweat gland, upon sebaceous gland, oil glands, all increase. Upon that, the body hairs you will get. These are the many changes. Upon that, there is a changes occur like hormonal changes in your body. Because of that, you will get some other external and internal changes. Okay, sometimes you will be short temper, you will get angry soon. You are feeling to make friendship more and more. Just avoiding the parents, all those things comes under in this only when you are reaching the adolescence. What about in girls? When the girl child, she reaches to its adolescence, there is some changes. External and internal, I am saying external changes like the development of mammary glands in her breast. Upon that, the hair growth in pubic regions, underarms, all those things. Same as that sweat and sebaceous glands, main one more point, she will get melodious, high pitch sound she will get comparing to the boys. Boys are getting very rash sound, but she will get, or as girl when she reaches to the adolescence, how nicely she can sing. Yeah, upon that, short temper, all those things. Upon that, the hormonal changes, beautiful color, nice texture of hair, many difference she can see externally. Internal changes also occurs like hormonal changes, the production of hormone, different sexual hormones, secondary sexual characters both in male and female. Okay, so there are number of changes occurs in the age of adolescence, when you reaches the age of adolescence. Okay, but it may vary from one individual to another. In all, it does not mean all have to get in the same age. It may vary. Boy or girl, they will get their maturity, or else they will reach the puberty when they are reaches to the PUC classes, like that. Some will get very soon. There is one more thing, that is menstruation will start for the girls. What it means, menstruation? Actually, that is also a type of reproductive development in her body. So we are going to study that detail in our next class. Okay, in today's class we will more concentrate on the male reproductive system. Okay, male reproductive system. Yes, we'll see what are the changes and what are the different systems or as parts involved in the reproductive parts in human beings. Okay, male reproductive parts. Yes. Now, it is not so easy, student. It is quite complex system they have. The boys have, or as the male have, quite complex system they have. which develop and function under the influence of hormones. Yes, under the influence of hormones. While we are talking about the hormone, we have to explain about, we have to think about the maturity. Because of the hormonal change, the male organism or else a male human, he is getting what a maturity, or else he is getting the changes in his body. Okay, I said almost it is 13 to 14 years in male. Okay, that is adolescence age we are saying, or the maturity time, but it is varies. Yes. Now we'll see what are the main parts involved in the male reproductive system. That is testes, a pair of testes, a duct, accessory glands and penis. These are the four main parts. It involves in the reproduction, or else it is the main parts in the reproductive system. To understand the male reproductive system, we have to know the structure of reproductive part in male. Okay, so have a look. See, this is a rough diagram I have drawn to you. See, student, this is a human male reproductive system. We can see number of parts here, so don't make confused. After studying, after getting the ideas, or else after getting the functions of each, you will get very easily what is it, what it indicates, or else what is the purpose of this different parts. Okay. Now, first part that is here, that is a testis, that is called as testis. In man and most animals, it is in oval body suspended in the sac hanging. See here, sac hanging from the lower wall of the abdomen. See, in lower wall of the abdomen, we can see this, okay, like a hanging it is, like a bag it is. Okay, actually this is present outside the body. Okay, not inside the body, we can see outside it is. Okay, so where it is, see, this is, it is located in the scrotum. Located in the scrotum. Okay, scrotum is protecting these testes. Testes are placed inside that one. Now, what is the function of this one? Yes, we know that main reproductive part is a testes in male. It is going to secrete a gamete called sperm or spermatozoa. We know that sperm or spermatozoa. Now, what is the structure of that sperm, student? Yes, we know that in lower class we studied. See, this is the structure of sperm. It has a head and middle region, upon that tail. This is a simple structure of sperm. Okay, now sperms, human sperms cannot develop at high temperature. Because of that, hence the testes are suspended outside the body. In exam, they will ask why the testes are placed outside the body. Because in high temperature, it won't produce sperm. So what happened? See how the creation of God, how wonder it is. By knowing all those things, he created like this. Because of that only, it is placed outside the body. Okay, we have to appreciate him. See, we have to appreciate God. How nicely he created a human body. Okay, by seeing its function, because it can't produce sperm when it is high temperature. So, to maintain the temperature, it is placed outside. Okay. Yeah. Next, found in the body cavity. Sperm cannot develop at the high temperature, found within the body cavity. Hence, the testes are suspended outside the body. Okay. Next, we'll see what is there inside the testes. Each testis is composed of 200 to 300 coils. That is called as seminiferous tubules. Now, where it is? If it is a testis, there will be a number of coils here inside that one, that is called as seminiferous tubules. Okay, lined within epithelial cell. These are lined with epithelial cells. Okay, that produce male hormones also. What happens? This is producing, testis is also producing sperm and a male hormone called testosterone. What is that? Testosterone. Yes. Now, it promotes the development of accessory glands, upon that control secondary male sexual character. This testosterone hormone control the glands, upon that secondary sexual hormones. Okay, sexual characteristic along with the formation of spermatozoa. There are three functions: formation of spermatozoa or sperm, control the secondary sexual characters, upon the development of accessory glands. Yes, that is the function of testes. Next we'll see second one, that is epididymis. Okay, now tell me where we can see this epididymis. See somewhat here, after the next, before next, see this is the testis, next here this part is called as epididymis. Can see now? Yes. See, this is made up of the compact mass of small coiled tubular forming. Okay, coiled tubular forming, almost it has a 6 cm in length. Okay, now what is the function of this one? See, testis is continually, it is producing the sperm, spermatozoa, gametes and hormones. What happened? It is going to store, the sperm is going to store temporary in epididymis. While we are studying the digestive tract, we studied that waste material temporarily it is going to store in the rectum. Okay, in urinary bladder, in bladder we come to know that after that there is a temporary storage in our excretory system. Same as that, there is a temporary storage of sperm in epididymis. In exam they will ask such a questions. Okay, lies along the sides of the testis in the scrotal sac. Okay, next. Both testis and epididymis together constitute testicles. What is that? Testicle. Okay, both epididymis and testis together, it is called as testicles. In exam for 1 mark they will ask. Okay, next, epididymis stores the sperm, filters them and make them motile by the time they reaches to the posterior part connected with the vas deferens. So what it is going to do? Filtering and make them motile. It is responsible, this epididymis is giving chance to that one to, it is helping to the sperm to for the moving purpose, it is going to help for the movement. Okay, next, it is connected with the vas deferens. Can you see here? This is epididymis. It is connected with the vas deferens. This is the vas deferens. Okay, next, chemical produced by the lining of the tubes are essential for the maturation of the sperm. Okay, so what happened here? Chemicals produced by the lining of this wall. Lining of these walls, what happens? It is helping for the maturation of sperms. Next we will see next part, that is called as vas deferens. Okay, vas deferens. See, it is a muscular tubes about 40 centimeter long. See, it is a tubes like this. It has a 40 centimeter long in its size. Okay, that leaves the scrotum. From where it start? From the scrotum by the it start like this and it will end up like this. See here, it is leaves the scrotum by the inguinal canal and emerges with the duct from the bladder into the urethra. So this is the bladder and it is reaches like this. See how it is going like this and it reaches here and once again it is coming like this. See, that is all about the vas deferens. The terminal position of each vas deferens, see, in one testis we can see same as in other testis. There are two testis are there. So what happened? In in what see the terminal position of each vas deferens enlarges to form a duct capable of contraction and expulsion of the stored sperms. So what happened, it is going to see when it is storing the sperm, when it is necessary it is transferring like this, it means that like that only, that much it is going to reach like this and here, see. Okay, that is all about the what a vas deferens. And the glandular seminal vesicles duct before it connects are urethra. So what happened, it is connecting to the urethra. Next, what happened, the secretion of viscous fluid. In this there is a secretion of viscous fluid which is expelled along with the sperm. It is expelled along with the sperm. So what happens, there is a secretion of fluid that is coming down along with the sperm. The mixture of this fluid and sperm is called as semen. So it is going to secrete one fluid along with the sperm, that is called as semen. Semen means what now? Fluid created or secreted in the vas deferens plus sperm. Okay, that is called as semen. Next we will see next part, that is these two part, that is the vas, sorry, prostate glands. See, these are the prostate glands. See here, I have mentioned here. See, these are the, see here like this, these are the prostate gland. Here one I have drawn, see, that is a prostate gland. Okay, now what is the function of these prostate gland? These are paired glands. Actually they are the paired glands. There are two glands are there. They are the paired glands lining below the bladder around the junctions of the ejaculating duct. Junctions of the ejaculating duct of two sides with the urethra. Okay, in this we can't see clearly. Okay, if you are getting any videos or as any 3D structures, you can see clearly, you can observe that one. Now what it happens, ejaculating duct of the sides with the urethra. Next, these discharge its secretions. This is also secreting something directly into the urethra. This is secreting directly into the urethra. See, where is the urethra here? Say it is going to secrete here. There is a common passage from this, from the urinary bladder, from the urinary bladder, from the this one. So there is a common passage for the both urine as well as this semen. Okay, now what happened, this discharge its secretion directly into the urethra, which has alkali nature and contributes 50 to 30% of total volume to the semen. So what happened, semen secreted from this is having low quality or as low volume, less volume it is. But what happened, it is secreting one more fluid, that is alkaline, and it is increasing its volume. So volume is increased because of this prostate gland. Okay, come to know. No, next will one more gland is there, that is a Cowper's gland. Cowper's gland, these paired glands are also attached to the urethra. They are also attached to the urethra. It is not mentioned in your textbook. It is also attached to the urethra. Here we can see, here see, these are the glands. One more gland is there over there. Okay, attached to the urethra about 5 cm below the prostate gland. They secrete an alkali substance which serves the lubricant for the semen. That is also a alkali substance that is serves the lubricant for the semen. Next part is a penis. See here we can see, this is the penis. Now what is the function of this penis? Why this penis is needed? The penis is the external male genital organ. In exam they will ask which is the external male genital organ, that is a penis. It is composed of three columns of spongy tissues. Here it has spongy tissues. Very spongy it is. So, okay, it's own function. Why it is need so spongy? So delicate, so soft it is. Okay, that is a spongy tissues present in the present in the penis. Okay, that is present in the penis. Last one more point, student, that is a seminal vesicle. Where we can see the seminal vesicle? See here, seminal vesicle. See, seminal vesicle, it can be seen at the base of the urinary bladder. Actually, we can see at the base of the urinary bladder it is. Okay, urinary bladder. They secrete mucus and watery alkaline fluid. It is secreting mucus. You know that what is mucus? Mucus and alkaline fluid that contain nutrition. That contain nutrition for what? Nutrition for the sperms. Upon that, including the sugar, fructose, which is an energy source to the sperm. There is the energy that is boosting the sperm. They are giving the energy for the sperm for to active. Okay, each seminal vesicle aptize its contents into the ejaculating duct, adding the volume of the semen. So all it is doing what? It is boosting the sperm and it is going to increase the volume of the semen. Okay, these all about the male reproductive part. Okay. So in today's class, what and all we studied about the male reproductive part, in that we come to know that there is a different parts are present in the male reproductive part. Different parts like from testes it will start, testes, epididymis, scrotum is discussed, vas deferens, urethra, see here urethra, seminal vesicle, bladder, prostate gland, penis and urethra. These are the number of different parts. See, draw and study the diagram. Diagram is very, very important, student. In exam, they will ask, need to label diagram with explanation. Okay, so write down today's questions. First question, explain male reproductive system with neat label diagram. Okay, now one more question. What are the functions of prostate gland and seminal vesicle? Next, one more question. Which is a male gamete and name the female gamete? Thank you, students.